Good evening, folks, and welcome to episode 96 of The Organist Entertains. Now, this is not the usual setting for our introductions, our greetings and our hellos, but I am loaded with a summer cold, and I don't know if you can hear, but this isn't the usual Maestro's voice. So the introductions are going to be short and sweet tonight, but that allows you to have less waffle from me and more music from the organ and more of your requests. So tonight's episode 96 contains a bumper selection, a plethora of requests and suggestions and favourite pieces of music. So without any further ado and more waffling from me, let's go over to tonight's first item, shall we? Tonight's first item is the favourite hymn of one of our church's new elders. Ian Gibb was ordained the same day as myself, on the 29th of May, and that particular Sunday, we sought the favourite hymns from Ian and myself. Ian suggested two hymns, one of which that was included was Nearer My God to Thee, but the second of Ian's favourite hymns, requests for that Sunday, was Thine Be the Glory, Risen Conquering Son. And it's that hymn that we have tonight, starting off episode 96. So thanks, Ian, for such a wonderful hymn, which is one of your favourites.
Thank you.
our second item tonight, the second request, is All in the April Evening, that wonderful choral song that we will all know and love. And I know that the choir at Belsall Central still enjoy singing it. It's been requested tonight by Mary Matthew, because this week is both the anniversary of her mum, my gran's, passing some 18 years ago, and also when her birthday falls on the 1st of July. So that's why it's been requested tonight, All in the April Evening. The next item, and these introductions are going to be short. It's the hymn Through All the Changing Scenes of Life, and that has been requested by our friend Ed Anderson from all the way over in South Africa. We wish you well, Ed, and hope everything's doing okay on almost the opposite side of the world. Your hymn request is set to the tune of Wiltshire, which we will all know over here in the United Kingdom and over in Scotland particularly as the alternative tune to The Lord's My Shepherd. So thanks, Ed, for keeping in touch, sending your requests, and for tonight's request through all the changing scenes of life. Well, we stick with Ed with our next request, and it's the hymn, The Lord's My Shepherd, I'll Not Want. Not to Wiltshire, but to the tune of Brother James's Air, a lovely, sweet and delicate melody, which we'll all know, perhaps as choir singers or going and listening to choir concerts. And Brother James's Air is another of these tunes, arrangements made famous by Sir Hugh Robertson and his Orpheus Choir. So thank you, Ed, for your request, The Lord's My Shepherd, to the tune Brother James's Air. Thank you. Well, we now have two hymn choices from our friend, the Reverend Tony Newnham. The first of Tony's requests is the hymn, O God of Burning, Cleansing Flame, Send, Send the Fire. It's found in Mission Praise, and it's got a syncopated rhythm to it. So I hope I've got it right, Tony, and I hope that everyone enjoys hearing this wonderful Pentecost hymn tonight. O God of burning, cleansing fire, send, send the flame. Tony's second request tonight is the hymn, My Jesus, I Love Thee. And I know that this has been requested in the past from Ed and Sheila Miller. However, it's been set to different tunes on those previous occasions. Tony has requested that we sing it to the tune called Gordon, which is a little bit familiar to me, but I have to admit, it is a new one for me. So thank you, Tony, for this second request tonight, which I'm sure is one of your many favourite hymns, especially since you're a retired minister and still a very active organist. My Jesus, I Love Thee, set to the tune called Gordon. Thank you. Now, our next request has been requested for quite some time, and I'm not entirely sure why I've never gotten round to record it, but apologies, humble apologies to Uriris, Nikki, Ainsley. It's simply entitled The Prayer, and we're all going to know this from the duet by Celine Dion and Andrea Bocelli. It's a wonderful song with wonderful words, which are quite simply a prayer to God. And we thank Nikki Riris for requesting it. And I'm sorry it's taken quite so long to get there. Keeping in the Ainsley household, we now have a favourite hymn of Hugh Ainsley. It's quite appropriate for the season that we're in. However, I'm not entirely sure what the weather will be like when this episode comes to you on Friday. It's the hymn Summer Suns Are Glowing Over Land and Sea. And it's always a hymn that you wonder, should we choose it or should we not choose it for Sunday services? Because it would seem perhaps a little odd singing about summer suns when the rain is battering off the roof. However, the sun is always shining somewhere, so if we sing it and it's quite wet and miserable outside, we are reminded that summer suns are glowing somewhere. So thank you, Hugh, for a hymn which is to the tune called Ruth, and I'm sure we'll all enjoy singing along and remember it fondly. Summer suns are glowing. We're coming to the final portion of tonight's episode 96, and I do hope that you are bearing with me as I introduce these hymns in a slightly different way. Our next hymn choice comes from our friend Anne White in Ireland. It's the hymn, Who is on the Lord's Side? Who will serve the King? Words written by Francis Ridley Havergal, if memory serves correct. We're going to have this twice. We're going to have it to the tune, which I think we're all going to expect it to be played to, and that's called Armageddon. We're then going to have it again, and we're going to have it to the tune called Rashi. And it's a wonderful Welsh tune, which I'm sure we'll all know. And if you want to later on, look it up on YouTube and hear some wonderful male voice choirs singing it. It's a wonderful Welsh Valleys hymn tune. So thank you, Anne, for requesting Who is on the Lord's Side? And thank you for choosing it because it reminded me of the lovely other tune which we're going to hear. So, to begin with, Armageddon, followed by Rashi. Well, our penultimate hymn choice tonight comes to us from Sheila Miller. It's the hymn Great God of Wonders. And she says that it's terrific words. And the words are by Samuel Davies. The tune is called Sovereignty by John Newton. And this is a wonderful Methodist hymn, which I'm sure Ed is going to be looking up in his hymn book as this introduction continues. So thank you, Sheila, for a wonderful hymn. And we are going to enjoy a tune which was new to me called Sovereignty. And for the musical people amongst us that read music and follow along, it starts off in 4-4 time, which you might want to call march time. And then the refrain goes into 3-4 time, which is waltz time. And it took me a moment or two to get my head around the change of rhythm and timing. So I hope everyone enjoys this hymn, requested tonight by Sheila.
Thank you.
Well, we still have our last hymn to go, but the final request tonight comes from Peggy Walker. And it's something that she mentioned when we were in church. And it's called the Hymn to the Fallen. And it's the theme tune, opening melody, music to the hymn Saving Private Ryan. And it's by that great master of music of all things film and big screen, John Williams. So I do hope that you enjoy hearing some softer sounds from the organ, a little distant sounding bugle call from the swell organ's oboe. And then when that comes back at the end, it's a little bit more closer, and we get that effect by using the swell horn, which is just a slightly more louder stop than the oboe. And apologies for those who are used to hearing it on the big screen. This is the Bells Hill Central organ version of Hymn to the Fallen, the theme music from Saving Private Ryan. Thank you. Our final hymn choice tonight is a hymn that, as I've introduced each of these hymns, I've probably said something similar, that it's a hymn that we're all going to know and we're all going to love. But this one is a particularly good sing. It's been requested by Jane Anderson, a member of Bells Hill West Parish Church Choir, and it's the hymn Blessed Assurance. It's a song and a hymn that reminds Jane of her childhood at Bothwell Hawk. So thank you, Jane, for requesting Blessed Assurance and the hymn which finishes tonight's episode. Thanks for sticking with us tonight for episode 96, edging that little bit closer to the special 100th edition. Tony's already been in touch to say that he has an idea for episode 100, so we're looking forward to knowing what that idea is, and we hope that you, Tony, can perhaps take part, albeit virtually from your music room, in episode 100. And anyone else who has ideas and suggestions about how we might celebrate episode 100, please get in touch. So thank you all for sticking with us tonight, and apologies for my croaky and not usual speaking voice. I hope you've been able to hear me okay, and that you've not missed some long rambling introductions. So thank you once more for joining us. If you feel able to make a donation, there is a link in the box down below somewhere that allows you to do so. And if you do, we're very grateful here at Bells Hill Central for any financial contribution and donation that you can make. Stay safe. Keep well. If you catch a summer cold, I hope it doesn't last as long as mine has. And we'll see you in 2 weeks' time for episode 97.